Hi, welcome to this lecture. In this lecture, I'm going to discuss you about for loop statements. What is for loop? Why we require to use this for loop? The statement of loop is itself, it is there. A block of code is going to be iterating or running repeatedly till the condition to be true or false, like reaching the threshold. And here I would like to discuss you whenever, how it is going to be important rather than while and do while, for loop is so important. Whenever you have an idea and how many iterations your loop should be run, and based on the condition, you will try to use the for loop statements. And it's a very simple and easy to use the for loop as well. See, here I'll discuss here a few points regarding this. For loop syntax would be like here, for with the open and end braces, and int I that equal to the initial value here only I'm declaring with the terminate. Okay, so it's not one, it's a I. Yeah. Terminate and I less than 5, I less than or equal to which operator you want, you can put here, no problem. And I plus plus. Where is this? Yes, I plus plus. So this is. And we are going to be writing open and end braces here. This is the block of for loop statements. This is the block of statement to be executed here. So the for loop will be on a single line, will be completed, three statements will be there here. The first statement, it will be says that initial value, the initial position of loop iterations. And the second statement, it will be says the condition. What is the condition you are going to be specifying here? It might be your interest. And you may know the how many lines of, or you may specifying any, instead of 5, you can specify also a dynamic variable also. Or any dynamic variable, data parameters, or table rows, anything it would be possible. But all you need to know about how the for loop statement is going to be executed. That I will explain you here. See, once the condition is verifying, it will be make a move to I plus plus, like incrementing of the value with plus 1. So I'll implement here CW, console.writeline, and I'm going to print I value only we are going to be printing here. Yes, with the concatenation also you can print how we are going to printing value of I is the concatenation I. That's it. So we are going to get this I value. So if I run, same thing will be get. See, from the initial position 0 we have given, value of I is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. The text additionally I'm getting. Why I'm getting a test? Here I am writing. That's it. What you have learned from previous lectures, you have to apply in our next lectures one by one. Making more productivity, you will be learn more things. See how it is going to be executed. On initial position, it will be the value will be initiated with the 0 and it will be entered into the loop. Now it is going to be it is an I less than 5 now. So it is entering into the loop. So console.writeline, it will be printing 0. And it is once the 0 console line, if it is printed, it will be a block end, and it will go to here, the incrementing of the value, I plus plus. Again, it is going to be verifying the condition, it is printing. 2, plus plus, 3, verifying, 3 is less than 5, so it is printing 3. Again, it is plus plus, 4, it is less than, so it is printing this statement. And it is going to be 5. And it's not satisfying the value, it's not less than or 5. So it will be terminate the loop and it will exit. If I'm making here I less than or equal to, it will be we have seen earlier 0 to 5, 4 only. Now it is going to be 5 also will be considered. See here 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Why? We are adding less than or equal to operator. So it will be. How simple it is, how easy. If I am placed here I want to run 500 or 5000, any number you want, run this, and we'll see. The loop iterations, it repeatedly it is going to be executing. See how many, like see the 500 it is printed. The loop statement it is going to be executing 500 times. If I am placed over here 5000 like execute, yes, don't worry, it will be taken care. See, wow, this is the advantage. The 500 like 5000 lines I am reading, it's a fraction of seconds only. See the 5000 it is printed and the program is terminated. How simple it is, the loop statements. Even 5 lakhs or 5 crores, yes, you can use. So this is the major advantages of using loop statements. And I would like to tell you a few things. Like I'm taking as an 10 as my value, and I++ using instead of I++, I'm doing trying to incrementing my value with the 2. I equal to like I plus say that 2. Now see, on every intervals it will be incremented by 2. Yeah, see 0, 2, 4, 6. I have taken I value like on verification of condition, I have taken 10. So till 10 it is receiving. So 0, 2, 4 plus 2 intervals it is incrementing the I value. If I am changing to plus 5 means 2 only iterations will get. See, execute. The I value is incrementing by 5 itself. So we are getting 0, 5, 10 intervals. If you want 1, 2 multiplies, what is the letter you want to execute and you want to see the output, you can play more and more. These all are very simple and easy, I hope so. Try to practice more and more. In our upcoming lectures also, we'll see like a few more interesting statements like this. Thank you for watching this session. Thank you.